John Morrell, Fragrance Review. Here comes the swag. John Morrell, Fragrance Review. Here comes the swag.
Hello, my friends. Welcome to my home studio in the beautiful Catskill Mountains in upstate New York. I am John Morrell. And I had an amazing idea from a new subscriber. I think it's been a couple weeks now, maybe a week or so. But he had a great idea. His name's Bren. And Bren's idea was to do a video on, he called it Great Deal Steal Video. So what that means is, this for me is going to be, I was at a rack store, and the fragrance was such a good deal, I could not pass it up. It was such a good deal, I had to buy it, even if I didn't really want it or wasn't looking for that fragrance. I think it's an amazing idea. So this is going to be my Great Deal Steal video, and it's thanks to Bren. I have quite a few of these on the list, actually. I'm going to try to limit it because if I'm in Marshall's, for example, if I see a fragrance that's even a couple dollars more than what I could get it for on fragrancenet.com, I buy it because I don't have to wait for the shipping. I'm crazy like that. So first one I'm going to talk about, and I've mentioned this fragrance before, is Dolce & Gabbana Intenso. Yes, this fragrance I love. I've talked about this. To me, it's the quintessential brunch fragrance. But this thing starts off with a lavender. It has some water notes, basil, marigold, geranium. But I have to tell you, I get, and there is a fruity accord on the middle notes, but what I get is lemon off the top. I really do. On my skin, I get a lemon meringue sort of lemon. It's bright. The basil tames the sweetness. There's a hay in the middle note. I really like this. This is not a wow fragrance. It's not a wow fragrance, but it is a very, very solid and well-blended fragrance. And I think I got it at Marshall's for like $26. I mean, it was totally worth it for a 2.5. So yeah, I don't regret this at all. It was a blind buy. I couldn't smell it. It was in a package, but I don't regret it. It's a very, very solid, well-blended fragrance. So that's the first one that I could not stop myself from buying. So Great Deal Steal Intenso. This one to me is the best deal you could get on a fragrance for what it is. I was absolutely shocked. I never even considered buying this fragrance because it kind of looked, you know, sometimes the bottle, if it looks like a joke or it looks dated, the bottle, the package looks dated, I'm like, I don't know. And I never owned this fragrance, but when I saw for $9.99, I was like, okay, well, I have to buy it. I have to buy it. It probably sucks, but I have to buy it. And it was Versace Blue Jeans, and boy, was I wrong. I don't regret this. Talk about a great deal, $9.99, and this thing is solid. If you haven't had this, it does not smell dated at all. It has a Coca-Cola vibe to it, especially when it first starts out. But this thing dries down very nicely. It projects pretty well starting out. Obviously, it's not a longevity beast. We know this, right? But this is a very, very solid fragrance. And I put this on. My wife loved it right away. She's like, that smells great. And I said, you're not going to believe this. It's $9.99. And it's a very old fragrance. But it doesn't smell dated. So don't be shy with this. This is a nice fragrance, and it does smell very Coca-Cola-ish. But people say that about Creation E by Roja. Keep that in mind. And that's a fragrance that goes for $300. Now, I'm not saying this compares to that. It's not as complex. But this is a great fragrance. So if you can see this for $9.99, and they're all over the place at the rack stores, and you don't have this yet, pick it up. Totally worth it. This is the epitome of a great deal steal. Fragrance. That was just an amazing deal. Well, this is interesting. Okay, so I'm doing this for you. I'm doing this for you because this is one of my all-time favorite fragrances as far as tobacco or, you know, say nighttime or winter fall fragrances. And you've heard me mention this before, and it's John Varvatos or John Varvatos, people say, but it's John Varvatos Dark Rebel. Let me tell you something. This is at Marshall's on a regular basis for $26.99. This bottle right here, by the way, I bought retail at John Varvatos in New York City, where CBGB's used to be. I bought this from that store when it came out. I don't even remember. I don't want to think about what I paid retail. I probably paid $100 for it, is what I'm guessing. As usual, his fragrances go for initially. I bought that retail. However, I did, when I saw this at Marshall's for $26.99, I bought a backup bottle, which I gave away to a listener. Remember, I actually did. Oh, no, I didn't. I traded it away. I traded my backup bottle away to, and I'm saying listener, like this is radio, by the way. I traded this away to a buddy of mine and a subscriber, Ben. So I traded my backup bottle away. But when I see this again at Marshall's, and it will be there, when I see Dark Revel at Marshall's again for $26.99, you can best believe I am buying another bottle of it. This fragrance has rum, tobacco, cardamom, sugarcane, leather. Did Alberto Marias do this?
All right.
I was wrong about that, by the way. Dark Rebel was created by Rodrigo Flores Roe. Just to be clear about that, so I didn't want to attribute it to the wrong person. So there you go. But the next one for sure is Alberto Marias. And that is Aqua Essencial, the original, not the blue. Although I heard the blue's great. I don't have that one. But this wasn't on my radar. It really wasn't. Aqua Essencial Blue actually was on my radar because I had heard Ross talk about it. But this one wasn't. When I saw this for $25.99, I was like, you know what? Let's give it a shot. And am I glad I did? This is an outstanding fragrance. It's a banger, and it doesn't last long. Fresh fragrances typically don't, but not bad. I'd say a good hour and a half, 2 hour projection, and I would say it lasts 4 or 5 hours, and it's a skin scent, which is cool. You know, I'm fine with that, and then it dies down pretty quick after that, but this is good. It has a mint, a lemon leaf, sea notes, lavender, geranium, and it dries into a musk, patchouli, vetiver. This is an outstanding, for the price, I think you can get this on FragranceNet super cheap, but I think I paid $25.99 for it, and I'm fine with that. That is a great deal steal in my book. Great deal steal was absolutely on my radar, but I just never saw it in the rack stores. I heard people saying they'd seen it, they'd picked it up, but in the rack stores around me, I just couldn't seem to find it. I saw other versions of this fragrance, but never the one I was looking for. And when I saw it in Marshall's, it was the last bottle. And if someone else was trying to grab that bottle, I probably would have knocked them over because I wanted this so badly. It was $19.99. And I'm talking about Abercrombie and Fitch First Instinct together. This is a dope fragrance. Green apple, pineapple leaf, grapefruit, cardamom on the top, a lavender, orange blossom middle note, musk, sandalwood, cedar at the dry down. And let me tell you, this fragrance is a banger. Absolute banger. This thing is fresh out of the shower, but it's better than that. It really is. It's a better fragrance than that, and it lasts longer than you think it might last. I like this fragrance, and plus for $19.99, just keep refreshing it. If you can get your hands on this, okay, if you can get your hands on this, it's upside down. It is. You can't help. Right? If you can get your hands on this for $19.99, my advice, grab it up. I don't regret this at all. Dope fragrance. One was my latest. The latest great deal steal that I found at a rack store, and it was something that I love John Favreau's fragrances, so I can't say it wasn't on my radar, but it wasn't something I probably would have ever bought if I didn't just stumble across it, and for a great deal. It was, I think this one was, I'm going to say $21.99 is what they had it, what they're selling it for, $21.99. And it was, not only was it a great pickup, it was a real surprise because It's John Varvatos, Artisan Blue. So with the saying Artisan Blue, I definitely had some ideas of what it smelled like. I definitely thought it was going to be, have some ambroxan in there or something like that. But I have to tell you, this was, in fact, it was such a surprise. I wasn't sure I liked it when I first put it on. I really wasn't. Because this is surprisingly a very green fragrance. I mean, listen, the top notes are bergamot, basil, lavender, bitter orange, but chayote, which is just like a green sort of green herbs and nuts. It's a combination of things, I guess. It sounds like a fantasy note or a created note, right? But the middle notes are geranium, orange blossom, clary sage, palmarosa, which again is more green notes. This is a very green fragrance with some citrus. Dries down to pine, pistachio, cedar, patchouli. I have to tell you, this is a surprising, very surprising fragrance. My advice is pick this up if you can. If you can smell it first, because it is a surprise. And I do think it takes a little, it took me two wears. It did. It took me two wears to get it. It took, when I say that, it's just because it was such an odd smell. Like, I was so taken back by it. I didn't look at the notes first. I put it on. I'm like, whoa, what am I smelling here? What is this? This is not a blue fragrance at all. I definitely thought it was going to have some water notes. There's none of that. There's no water notes. This isn't what you think, right? So I dug it, though. Now I dig it. Once I wore it a few times, I really liked it. So again, I got it for $21.99 at a rack store. And again, that is a great deal steal for sure, because this turned out to be very unique to me. I don't think this smells like anything else. Nothing I have. It's so green. I don't have a lot of green fragrances. I'm not necessarily a huge fan of them, but I like this one. And there's another one I like. Kenneth Cole Black Bold is surprisingly green too. But I didn't get that at a rack store though. But this will be the last one I talk about, because I have a bunch I got from rack stores, but these are the ones I'm going to talk about today. And I got great deals. And yeah, I mean, hey, I want to thank Bren very much for this idea. It was a great idea. I could have made this a tag video, to be honest. I think people would enjoy doing this. I really do. Great deal steal video. But there's so many tags going around. I'm afraid to tag people and have them go, I have like three tags I'm about to do. But should I tag Tyler? Tyler tags me. We tag each other. It's cool. Maybe I should tag Tyler on this. Should I make this a tag video? Bren, you would have started this tag. This could go viral and it'd be all you. I'm going to do it. You know what? Great deal steal video. In other words, fragrances you couldn't stop yourself from buying because the price was so good. Tyler from Simply Fragrances, I'm tagging you, buddy. Have fun. We out. John Morrell, fragrance review. Here comes the swag. John Morrell, fragrance review. Here comes the swag. Fresh and dope like heroin soap. That man's got swag.